Привет, and welcome to Lesson 7 of the Russian Language course. I'm your host, Dmitry Slomov. Today, we shall talk about going to a food store, and we shall get acquainted with some more Russian food stuff. Let's say Joanne, who lives at home of her Russian friend Vika, would want to have dinner. And for dinner, she would want some very special sort of Russian curd cheese, which is called творог. Творог. Творог is white, soft enough, one may easily knead it, and it is usually dry. It may resemble cottage cheese, but it is much drier and looks more like paste. Творог with sour cream is a rather common dish in Russia. It may be eaten for breakfast or for dinner. One may add sugar or honey or jam, варенье, to it. Or it may be also eaten with potatoes, onions, vegetables or fruits, whatever. One may even bake it. So, Joanne wants to have some творог for dinner. She has a look into the fridge, and she finds that there is no творог. So she wants to say, there is no творог at home. Or, in Russian way, something like, at home, there is no of творог. At home, in Russian, дома. Дома. You surely remember the word for going home. To home, actually. Домой. But at home, дома. There is no sounds the same as no. Нет. Нет. Now, if you want to say that there is творог, you say есть творог. But if you want to say that there is no творог, you say нет творога. The word творог gets the ending а, because it is like there is no of творог. Нет творога. The same way we may say that there is, say, sugar. Есть сахар. But there is no sugar. Нет сахара. Нет сахара. There is tea, есть чай. There is no tea, нет чая. The words get an ending «а». So Joanne says, дома нет творога. Дома нет творога. Now she checks if there is bread. Bread in Russian – хлеб. Хлеб. There is bread. Есть хлеб. There is no bread. Нет хлеба. Нет хлеба. So Joanne sees that there is also no bread. Also, тоже. Тоже. Starts the same way like the English word to. Тоже. And it may mean also, or to, or neither. So, Joanne says in Russian way, of bread also there is no. Хлеба тоже нет. Хлеба тоже нет. And she proposes to Вика that she would go to a shop. I shall go, пойду. Remember, let's go or we shall go, пойдем. Пойдем. But when one is speaking about himself or herself, I shall go, я пойду. Я пойду. A shop, магазин. Магазин. Exactly like the magazine you may buy in some shops. Магазин. To a shop, в магазин. So Joanne offers that she would go to a shop. Я пойду в магазин. Я пойду в магазин. Вика decides she wants to go to the shop too. So she says, I want to go to the shop too. Or actually, I too want to the shop. I too shall go. To – тоже. I want – хочу. So Вика says, Я тоже хочу в магазин. Я тоже пойду. Я тоже хочу в магазин. Я тоже пойду. Joanne replies, Fine, let's go together. Together, вместе. Вместе. Now, try to say for Joanne, Fine, let's go together. Great. Хорошо. Пойдем вместе. Or, хорошо. Пошли вместе. If they're going right away. Let's summarize the conversation between the ladies. Вика, дома нет творога. Хлеба тоже нет. Я пойду в магазин. Я тоже хочу в магазин. Я тоже пойду. Хорошо. Пойдем вместе. Great. Now, before going out, Вика takes a look into the fridge. She wants to know, maybe there are some more goods that she will need to buy. She looks and says, So, there is milk, there is white bread, and there is also mineral water. Milk, молоко, молоко, similar to milk, молоко. White bread, there are various sorts of white bread in Russia, and they have various names. Let's consider one of the most common. It looks like a wide and relatively short baguette, and it tastes like baguette too. It is called baton. Baton. Butter, a very useful thing if you want to make a sandwich. Don't know about your country, but in Russia one usually makes a sandwich from baton or bread, butter, and something more. Cheese, sausage, jam, and so on. So, butter in Russian sounds масло. Масло. Like, if butter is spread on the road, you must slow. Must slow. Масло. Now, so in Russian, так. Так. It also may be used like a silence filler. Like, in English one may say, well, well. Not meaning that something goes really well, but just to fill the silence, or to start a sentence. In Russian you do it with так, так. At home, remember? Дома. Вика says, так, дома есть молоко, есть батон, есть масло, минералка тоже есть. There is one more dairy product that is extremely popular in Russia. It is similar to yogurt, and it is manufactured in the same way. It is called kefir. Kefir. And finally, sour cream that is usually added to творог, because without it, творог is too dry. Sour cream in Russian, сметана. Сметана. Like some Mr. Sour Cream, Mr. S. Сметана. Сметана. Есть сметана. These are the chief products that Russians buy nearly every day. Now, the words get the ending «а» when you say that there is no something. Like «нет хлеба», «нет творога», «нет кефира». The words like «молоко», «масло», «пастри», «печенье», «джем», варенье that have endings or е, these words get their original endings or е changed to а. So this sounds like нет молока. Есть молоко, нет молока. Нет масла. Есть печенье, but нет печенья. Нет варенья. The only exception is the word кофе. Есть кофе, нет кофе. The word кофе does not change at all. Now, the word сметана has the ending а already. So, this already existing ending а changes to и. or sometimes to I. Есть сметана, нет сметаны. Есть минералка, нет минералки. Now, what does Vika not have? At home, there is no bread, no kefir, and no sour cream. You surely remember the word for and, are. This is used for a sort of comparison. I would want tea and John coffee. Я буду чай, а Джон кофе. Or everything is fine, and what about you? Все хорошо, а как у тебя? But if you are listing a number of things, for and you might use the word I. I. Like there is tea and coffee. Есть чай и кофе. Or Jack and Jill. Jack и Джилл. So Vika continues. Так, так. Дома нет хлеба, нет кефира, нет творога. И сметаны тоже нет. She wants to continue. We should buy bread, kefir, творог, and sour cream. Now, in Russian, when you want to say that someone should do something, you usually say like, it is needed to do something. Надо. Надо. Similar to needed. Надо. To buy, купить. Купить. Please pay attention to the soft T at the end. Now, remember how you said, I would want tea, or coffee, or mineral water? Я буду чай, или кофе, или минералку. The word минералка changed its A to U, because someone wanted it. There is mineral water, есть минералка. But I would want mineral water, я буду минералку. The same thing about sour cream. There is sour cream, есть сметана. I would want sour cream, я буду сметану. Я буду сметану. And when someone needs to buy it, надо купить сметану. Or надо купить минералку. All the rest of the goods that we have learned until now do not change if someone wants them or wants to buy them. They do not end with A. Only the words сметана and минералка do end with A, so we need to buy сметану or минералку. Vika says, надо купить хлеб, кефир, творог и сметану. And Joanne says, let's go together to a shop. Пойдем вместе в магазин. Vika is ready to go, and she says, пошли. Now, before we listen to the whole dialogue, let's summarize. We now know how to say that there is something, and we may point at it. Like, вот чай, вот кефир. We know how to say that there is no something, and that one needs to buy something, right? Now, I shall pass through the words from this lesson and from lesson about tea, and I shall say them in these three forms. Like, here is something, at home there is no something, we need to buy something. Ready? So, вот молоко. Дома нет молока. Надо купить молоко. Вот масло. Дома нет масла. Надо купить масло. Вот творог. Дома нет творога. Надо купить творог. Вот кефир. Дома нет кефира. Надо купить кефир. Вот батон. Дома нет батона. Надо купить батон. Вот хлеб. Дома нет хлеба. Надо купить хлеб. Вот сметана. Дома нет сметаны. Надо купить сметану. Вот минералка. Дома нет минералки. Надо купить минералку. Вот чай. Дома нет чая. Надо купить чай. Вот кофе. Exception. Дома нет кофе. Надо купить кофе. Sugar, remember? Вот сахар. Дома нет сахара. Надо купить сахар. Sandwich. Вот бутерброд. Дома нет бутерброда. Надо купить бутерброд. Pastry. Вот печенье. Дома нет печенья. Надо купить печенье. Jam. Вот варенье. Дома нет варенья. Надо купить варенье. Chocolate bar. Вот шоколад. Дома нет шоколада. Надо купить шоколад. Beer. Вот пиво. Дома нет пива. Надо купить пиво. Juice. Вот сок. Дома нет сока. Надо купить сок. Very good, very good. And now let's listen to the whole today's dialogue. Вика, дома нет творога. Хлеба тоже нет. Я пойду в магазин. Я тоже хочу в магазин. Я тоже пойду. Хорошо, пойдем вместе. Так, дома есть молоко. Есть батон. Минералка тоже есть. Так, так. Дома нет хлеба. Нет кефира. Нет масла. Нет творога. И сметаны тоже нет. Надо купить хлеб, кефир, творог и сметану. Пойдем вместе в магазин. Пошли. Now, let's listen to the dialogue spoken quickly. Вика, дома нет творога. Хлеба тоже нет. Я пойду в магазин. Я тоже хочу в магазин. Я тоже пойду. Хорошо, пойдем вместе. Так, дома есть молоко, есть батон, есть масло и минералка тоже есть. Так, так, дома нет хлеба, нет кефира, нет творога и сметаны тоже нет. Надо купить хлеб, кефир, творог и сметану. Пойдем вместе в магазин. Пошли. Very well done. So that's enough for this time. Drill the words and their endings. And see you in the next lesson. Пока.